Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point Scientific. Today I'm going to be taking you to school and teaching you all about bandpass, or the transmittability of a certain wavelength of light. Now in one of our most recent videos we talked about how to choose the right filter depending on the celestial object that you're shooting, but understanding bandpass is also equally as important. Stay tuned. Narrowband filters are designed to pass only a very specific wavelength of light, which is emitted by excited particles within emission nebula. These wavelengths of light are referred to as hydrogen alpha, oxygen 3, and sulfur 2. Now, generally speaking, the narrower the bandpass of your filter, the better the transmittability. But more on this in a moment. Let's take hydrogen alpha, for example, whose emission line sits on the spectrum at 656.3 nanometers. This emission line actually lies close to the middle of the red spectrum, which is rather wide and spans about 150 nanometers. With this being said, we can directly compare data collected from an Astrodon E-series red filter with a bandpass of 60 nanometers and an Astrodon hydrogen alpha filter with a bandpass of 3 nanometers. As you can see in this example, the difference between the two images is staggering. So as I stated earlier, the narrower the bandpass of your filter, the better the detail, the contrast, and the light pollution reduction capabilities. Now that being said, there are a slew of different bandpasses, and that goes for all hydrogen, oxygen, and sulfur filters. The common ones are 3 nanometer, 5 nanometer, 7, and 12 nanometers. Now we highly recommend the 3 nanometer and the 5 nanometer filters, but they tend to be a bit more expensive, and for good reason. If you live in a very light polluted area or you're imaging during a full moon, you're going to want to find the narrowest bandpass filter that you can, especially in your oxygen 3 filter. So one thing to consider when purchasing narrowband filters is your telescope's or camera lens's focal ratio. If you have a fast telescope or lens like the Celestron Rasa, for example, or the Takahashi Epsilon, you're going to actually want a wider bandpass, 7 nanometers or even up to 12 nanometers, simply because of something called band shift, which is the shifting of the wavelength outside of your filter's bandpass. Now this occurs because of something called the angle of incidence. We recommend that you do your own research into this if you're curious, as we are not optical professionals. So what this generally means is that you're not maximizing your filter's potential. If you have any questions about this, please contact us at High Point Scientific and we'll be more than happy to help you choose your filter. So to sum all of this up, narrowband filters allow for a very specific wavelength to pass through the filter and hit your camera sensor to allow for maximum contrast, detail, and light pollution blocking capabilities. The narrower the filter, the better. In most cases, if you have a fast telescope or a fast focal ratio camera lens, you're going to want to consider a 7 nanometer or a 12 nanometer filter to prevent band shift. So finally, don't take all of this too seriously. 3 nanometer and 5 nanometer filters are fantastic and you will never go back, but the 7, the 8.5, and the 12 nanometer filters are also really great at blocking light pollution and giving you awesome color and detail and contrast. So if those are the only ones that you can find, you will be perfectly happy with them. If you want a bit more information, take a look in the description below, as our very own Kyle has written an incredible article all about choosing the right filters, bandpass, filter sizes, narrowband, and LRGB filters. It may have all the information that you need to know. That being said, we thank you so much for tuning in. If you have any additional questions, reach out to us at highpointscientific.com and our non-commissioned product advisors will be more than happy to assist. Clear skies.